Dr. Murmurs. And who do we have here?
Katie Woods.
Katie Woods. Okay. And what's your date of birth, Katie?
The 2nd of March, 1997.
Okay. 1997. So you are here today for a cranial nerve examination. Mm. Have you ever had one of these before?
No, I've not.
You've not had one. Okay, so what I'll do is we're going to test different nerves in your body today. And I will explain to you as we go through each nerve and each test what I'm doing and why I'm doing it, okay? So before we begin, I just need to double check a few things for you. Turn this over. Okay, so have you had any accidents at all in the last 12 months?
Nothing.
No accidents? No concussions?
Nope.
No concussions. Okay. Any medical conditions I need to be aware of?
Nope.
None. How would you describe your exercise?
I'm pretty active.
Active. Okay, alcohol use?
Moderate.
Moderate. Partying, university?
Yes, of course.
Okay, do you smoke?
No.
Take drugs?
No.
And generally you feel well?
Yep.
Okay. Feel well. Right. So there are 12 cranial nerves that we're going to look at today. We will start with your olfactory nerve. So your olfactory nerve is responsible for your smell. So I have a little test for you. I have 6 different aromatherapy oils and I'm not going to show you what they are. And you need to try and tell me what they are.
Okay.
Some of them are hard, so I will let you away with a few.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, the first one, just make sure you can't see that.
Lemon?
No. It's close.
Passion fruit? No.
You're close though with citrus.
Orange.
Orange. Sweet orange. Okay. That was quite hard because it does smell like lemon. Number 2. Oh, strong. You recognize this smell?
Don't recognize it.
Even if I left it. Just smells strong. Okay, that's peppermint.
Oh.
Okay.
Strawberry?
There's a fruit.
Passion fruit. Grapefruit.
One you've already mentioned. I'll give you that one though. Okay. This one will be quite hard. Okay. It's. I'll let you describe. What would you say?
It was like, it's really minty.
Would you say, what else? Minty.
It's a bit spicy.
Spicy, so would you say it's a herb?
Yeah, possibly.
Okay, any guess for what it is?
I'm unsure.
So it's rosemary. So you might then herbs, I'll give you that. And the final one. Okay. because even though you got some of them wrong, you were close, and that just might be because you don't recognise it. But I think your olfactory nerve is working correctly, so that's good. And some of them are quite hard. Alright, so now we're going to look at your optic nerve. Now your optic nerve is what provides you with sight. So we have quite a few tests here. The first of which is the visual acuity test. I assume you will have done before a Snellen chart at your optician.
Yep.
So I'm going to hold one of these up for you. Stand over here, okay?
Okay.
Now I want you to read top mark.
C H.
Okay.
S Z N D.
Mm-hmm.
K C R H N.
Mm-hmm.
Z K D V C O.
Mm-hmm.
H V O R K Z S.
Next line.
R H S O. D C V.
The next line.
K S V R H C O.
And the bottom line.
H N Z C D K R.
Perfect. Good marks. Well done. That's the visual acuity. Now going to have a look at the light reflex of your pupils. So if you don't mind, I'm going to shine a light in your eyes. So can you just cover this eye for me? What's that? Just covering the other eye. Working correctly. What I'm looking for there is your pupil. So I can see the muscles in the center of your eye, and your pupil becomes larger as the light goes away from your eye and becomes smaller as the light goes towards your eye. And they were working very well. So okay, now I just need you to now look at my finger. And follow it all the way to your nose and back out again. Okay, and then do it one more time. All the way to your nose and back out again. Great, that was good. Do your visual field test. So this is where you will cover one of your eyes again. And I'm going to move my fingers in and around your field, and I want you to tell me when that disappears.
Okay.
Actually, what I think we'll do is I'll start out of your field of vision and you tell me when it appears. Okay.
Okay.
Right, so we'll start with this eye. So if you cover that one. Can you see that?
Mm.
You can still see that? Okay. You can still see my fingers?
Mm.
No. Okay.
Yeah.
No. Okay. Can you see that?
No.
Yeah. Okay. No.
A wee bit, yeah. Yeah.
Okay.
No. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Next one.
Getting a cold.
Okay. just kind of a quick general look. What I'm going to do is pop some gloves on as well. While I do this, just have a general look at your eye health before we move on to the next step. You've got some eye makeup on. You don't ever have any problems at home for me. Okay. Look up. Okay. Do you ever get any irritation at all in your eyes? Okay. Look down. Look up. Okay. Down. And it's not sore anywhere around here. Just your sinuses are causing you a couple of problems at the moment from COVID as well. Right. Okay, so that is us for ear. Which is all around your eye area still. So we have some further movements. Okay. Right. So I need you to me. Okay. Look to your left. Look to your right. Look up. Look down. Center, to your left, to your right, up, down, center. Okay. So your next cranial nerve is cranial nerve number 5, the trigeminal nerve. And this is to do with sensation. So we have some sensory tests. One of them you might not like as much as the other. So I'm going to start with the nice one first. Okay. So what we want to do is test sensation of your face. So let's just say your face has multiple different innervation zones. So I will use a cotton pad. I'm going to very gently touch different areas of your face. And I can come down to around here. And then you have to tell me if you can feel it. And then we will move on to pain. I've got a really tiny sharp prick. It's like almost like a needle. It won't penetrate your skin at all. But you just need to tell me if you can feel pain sensation when I touch it with that.
Okay.
Okay, so we'll start with the cotton roll bud.
Do I keep my eyes open? Closed?
You can keep them open. You can close them if you wish. There's not much difference. What would you rather? Sensation is good. I'm gonna do the little sharp prick bit. You'll be fine, you look nervous. You'll be fine. Okay. it sore?
It was okay.
It's okay. So all of that, you got all of them there, so no problems at all there. So now we're going to look at the motor part of your visual nerves. So, what I need you to do is clench your teeth. Okay, clench them tight. I'm just going to feel all around in here. Your muscles are involved, so it's your masseter muscle. See how that feels. Okay, my knees. Good. Okay, now you need to clench again. This time I'm going to hold this. Holding it there. Okay. Just checking the resistance of your muscles. Now, if there's a problem with these muscles, I would expect to see your jaw swing to one side while I do that. But your muscles are firmly holding that in place, so that's great. Reflexes.
Okay.
Alright. I'm going to do your jaw reflex. So open your mouth and just like gently release and relax. You won't love this one either, so I'm just basically going to touch your cornea. Your facial expressions. So we have quite a few little tasks to do here. So I just need to now have a look at different expressions. So you could do a nice big smile for me. And frown. Shock. Sad. You could be an actress. Can you bear your teeth? Can you screw your eyes shut? Can you blow out your cheeks? Okay. some of these expressions, you're going to make them for me, and I'm going to use some resistance. So raise your arms up, and don't let me pull that down. Okay, fight against it.
Okay.
Right, blow your cheeks. Don't let me push the ear out. Okay, that's good. Screw your eyes shut, don't let me open them. Okay, not very good. Okay, so the vestibular cochlear nerve is cranial nerve number 8, which is responsible for your hearing. So that's where we have this. Do you know what this is? This is a tuning fork. So it makes sound. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to make sound with this. I'm going to bring it far away. And when you hear it come towards your ear, you just need to let me know that you can hear it. I'm going to do multiple different directions. And I'm also going to do it seated on the top of your head and also behind your ears as well. That's a good shot. Yeah, that works well. Okay. So. Can you hear that? Good muscles are working, but I think you may be slightly hard of hearing.
On my left side, it's harder to hear than my right side.
The left side. Have you even checked for this before?
Yes.
Okay. And what was the verdict at the moment for that?
It's not too bad that it would cause a problem.
Not too bad. But potentially you need to get that. But here you need to wear a leather jacket. Good. That's fine. Have you always had hearing issues?
Only till I got a bit older.
Do you have hearing issues that run in the family?
A little bit, yeah.
So, then we have the glossopharyngeal and the vagus nerves. Okay, so for glossopharyngeal nerve, what we're going to do is we're going to get right, which a lot of people don't like, but so I just need you to open your mouth wide and go ah. Sometimes you don't like to do this. Keep your mouth and then go ah. It's fine, you know, granny, you've been on displacement. Okay. Gag reflex. You can love this one, so I'm going to use this again. I'm going to check your gag reflex, okay? Okay. Your mouth wide. Okay, so that is your glossopharyngeal nerve. one over here. So we're going to look and your spinal accessory nerve. So what we'll do is this is those two with your traps, trapezius shoulder and your sternomastoid. So there's quite a bit of resistance testing here. So what I'll do is I'm going to take my gloves off. So I'm going to come right here. Okay. And I want you to try and shove your shoulders against my resistance, okay? That's good. Okay. Very good. Okay, if you could please set your tonic for me, that would be fab. Okay, looks good. Alright, so I'll just run through what my thoughts are. So, basically good news all round. So, your nerves are looking fab. So, with your olfactory nerve, your smellings, so you've got 5 out of 6, but that was more to do with unfamiliarity of the products rather than lack of smell. Then your optic nerve, so your visual acuity was 20 out of 20, it was fabulous. Your light reflex, your your pupils were fab. Then we had your reflex of your muscles of the eyes, they were great as well. Visual field was very strong, you've got very good eyes. Such good eyesight. Especially for a young person, do you wear glasses at all?
No.
Okay, then we just have the movement of your eyes and no problem there. Your sensory nerves are great, so you were able to test all of the cotton wool swab little sections and also the pain as well. Then the motor was great, you were able to clench down, you were able to provide resistance when I tried to move your hand. All of your reflexes were on point. Your hearing was the only thing absolutely lacking, and this wasn't anything to do with the. We were looking today at your vestibulocochlear. Vestibulocochlear nerve, cranial nerve, number 8. And I don't see a problem with that nerve, I think it's more of a problem within your internal ear system. So just keep an eye out for that. Then your remaining cranial nerves, there was no wasting there. You were able to fully use your trapezius and sternomastoid muscles. So yes, so all was very well. Do you have any questions for me at all?
No.
Did you enjoy your session today?
Yes, I actually did.
You did. Fabulous. Well, a pleasure to meet you.
You too.
And hopefully, all going well, we won't see you back here anytime soon.
Yeah. Okay, thank you.
Take care. Nice.